This is Chris Kuzman with your weekly Polo Fun Boxing Hour, brought to you by George Rogan Insurance, www.hssp.cSportsShoes.com. I have on the phone five-time Golden Gloves female champion, Tanzee Daniel. She goes by Sweet Tea. Tanzee, how are you doing tonight, lady?
I'm okay.
Beautiful. Awesome. We tried to get you on Thursday, and the storms coming through Chicagoland area did not allow us to get really good reception in the building we were in. And we apologize, but we are here to make it up and give you your fair airtime. So, again, please accept our apology. Awesome. We want to make sure we're on your good side because we're not very good fighters. No, we're good drinkers, but we're not very good fighters. So,
okay.
Beautiful. Tanzee Daniel, Sweet Tea, let's take it back a little bit to when you were a little girl, because most of the little girls I grew up with, they stood in their room and they looked at themselves in the mirror and they said, oh, I want to be a dancer, I want to be a lawyer, I want to be a doctor. What were you saying you wanted to be when you were little?
Well, actually, when I was little, I wanted to be a pilot and a basketball player.
Okay. So, where was the wild left turn that led you to a boxing ring?
Well, I was in college ball. I played AAU ball and I got tired of it, so I started seeing women's boxing on television. And it was getting popular. And I was going, girl, I was like, man, I can do that. I found a gym. Actually, this guy that worked at my job, he found a gym for me. And about three months before I actually went down there. And as a boxer.
Now, where are you from? Where do you fight out of?
Well, I fight out of Brotherhood Gym in Brooklyn.
Yeah. We just talked to your manager, Sean Joynes, who was bragging about you big time, about coming out of that Brooklyn gym and whatnot. At the same time as Shannon Briggs, obviously future former heavyweight champion of the world, yet he said while he was training one fighter, he found himself watching you more because of your awesome your skills in the ring and your defensive skills and whatnot. What's that like? That's a huge compliment right there.
Yeah, it is. You know, like I said, if I was training at Brotherhood, I wasn't guys to me. You know, I had a lot of great fighters there, and I learned a lot from observing, you know, while I'm training at the same time you're watching it, you pick up things. So I had a variety of fighters with different skills, and you kind of pick up these things as you go along. So I picked up a little bit from this one, that one practice, and, you know, I became weak, and then it's
easy. Give me some names. Who are some of the fighters that you've trained with?
Oh, I've worked with it. I'm cognizant of the contender. Me, Neil, Joe Green, who's undefeated right now. Showtime, Curtis Stevens. Jay Quintal, Iron Horse, Jab Judah. Oh, the names are listening.
Yeah, we've heard of those guys.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Talk about the relationship with Sean Joynes. How did that come about? We have his side of it. Let's hear your side.
Well, just like you said, he had a fighter that was down there, and he used to always be watching me, and I noticed, but at that time, you know, I was still amateur. So then I went up to him one day, and he spoke, and I told him, he asked me, like, what about as far as my amateur career, how long I want to stay amateur, you know, how do I feel about the pros, do I ever think I would become professional, and I told him, yeah, but I wanted to fight in the Golden Globes. You know, one more time, I'm trying to bring more through the record.
Sure.
Yeah, he's real close. So, good fight. You know, we had five in the night, but I came up short by 1 point.
Oh.
Yeah, I was in that slow. So, that's pretty much my point tonight.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I've got a couple more questions for you. I want to talk about this this lovely, sweet little young lady named Mayorga, who had a couple of choice words for you. Do you take the smack that people say about you and help fuel the fire for the fight, or do you just let it all roll right off? How do you take smack off like that?
Smack off helps, because that makes me think only one thing. She's ready. If you can solve a good one, you can bring a good one. When I come to you, I'm bringing everything I have. You know, I'll smack off at a minimum. I do in the ring.
Good. No, I mean... a lot of times we'll have fighters that especially her cousin, Ricardo Mayorga, who's going to be fighting this weekend up against Fernando Vargas. All kinds of, Ricardo Mayorga is sort of the king of smack talk. And when he fights Vargas this weekend, he's fighting another king of smack talk. So, your fight with the female Mayorga, I mean, they're hand in hand. They're hand in hand in the Mayorgas, the Nicaraguans actually talking as much as they do. So I'm glad to see that you allow that to just fuel the fire a little bit. And what are you going to do to her?
Oh, what a million. Well, anybody looks for knockouts. To me, knockouts, come when they come, I want to humiliate my fighter. I want them to say, God, that ain't fighting. She moves too much. She slips too much. Oh, she's pretty. Man, how can you make me fight like that? I want her to be me. I want to be me at the end of that fight.
Oh, okay.
You know, I want her a whole mindset. I want to be like, I want to be like that to her. She's slick, you know, she's sweet. That's me. I'm pretty when I fight. Right on my feet, you know? So she got it covered.
Well, we've got a rather, rather good female fighter in this area, in the Chicagoland area, actually Northwest Indiana, goes by the name Merciless Mary McGee. Your name has come up as a possible future opponent for Mary McGee. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, anyway, I'm ready to take on anyone. If she's a big name at that time, and she could just fight as long as she could just fight. I don't want to just fight in any side, you know? All is welcome. All is welcome.
So give me some names as to who you would like to see.
Who I would like to see fight?
Who you would like to fight?
Well, of course, you know, she's not fighting anymore. The main name would have been Ali.
Well, she has she officially retired?
Well, I heard so. This is a rumor I have that one. Her to come in on her claim herself. But she hasn't been in action for almost a year now.
Well, I know she hasn't been fighting, but if she hasn't officially retired, because I know Ann Wolf and her were supposed to tie up the loose ends and get that fight actually made. And then Layla decided she wanted to fight in Africa. She wanted to fight at Madison Square Garden. She couldn't decide really where that fight was going to end up happening. I'd like to see Tanzee Daniel actually get in there with a Layla Ali or even a Christy Martin or Mia St. John, Brooke Geerdorf. I mean, these are all names that are on their way into superstardom. Christy Martin.
I'm ready.
So you're ready for any of these people?
I'm ready for all of them, anybody. No one now. It's not going to be like, oh, no, I don't want to fight. I'm not dying in any books. I feel like I need to play my career. So I'm ready for this fight. I have a great amateur background, and I'm going to bring that into the book.
Well, talk a second about the difference between men boxing and female boxing in that men tend to find a weight and they stay there, and there's just so many male fighters, there's always going to be fights. But there's a problem sometimes with female fighters that moving around in weights just because there isn't as much competition. Is that frustrating for you or what?
Yeah, it's frustrating, but it's also challenging. You know, if you really want something really bad, you got to work hard. So if I know there's an opponent that's 10, 15, 20 pounds lighter than me, and that's the only way I can get a fight right away, then I'm going to work harder. You know, I'm going to look at that as a challenge. So, you know, being a negative is also a positive.
So what weight do you generally walk around at versus what weight you fight at?
Well, I walk around at like 190.
Okay.
You know, I walk around at like 190. So I figure I can fight anywhere from 168 and up. You know, and if I have to go down even smaller, that's possible too.
Yeah, we will definitely be going out of our way to be polite to you.
Hey, because, you know, when I fought in New York Boarding Gloves with one of my five brothers, I fought in different weight classes. I have those gloves in different weight classes, from 165 all the way up to super heavyweight.
So it's not like you just hung out at one weight and just
fluctuate, whatever they're going to fight. If they said 10, if you don't have anybody at 165, but we have a girl that's at 189, I said, I'm there. If they didn't have someone at 189, they had somebody at 220, and I'm weighing 190, I'm still there. I fought a girl that was 260, and I weighed in at 197 in the national, Tanzee Daniel, 3 was there.
There was a 260-pound female fighter?
Super heavyweight, yes, sir. In the 2004 U.S. Championship.
Tanzee, I'm 6 foot tall, and I'm a fat guy. I do not weigh 260.
That was a big deal.
That's a big deal. Oh, good Good God. Do you recall her name?
I had to put on weight because I was at 193.
Well, I had
a couple pounds, so that didn't even allow me to fight her.
260? Good God. Did she eat the referee?
I don't know, Thomas. She was 260, but she could move.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, she was a big girl, but she could move.
Well, hey, but she's got gloves on just like you.
I have to make some little gloves just like me.
Awesome.
At 260?
No, you don't want to feel any of that. Shoot.
You got that right.
You don't want 260 leaning on you either, for that matter.
Anything for that? Stick and move.
Excellent. No, good. Well, when does your fight with Mayorga take place?
At January 12th in Nicaragua.
January 12th in Nicaragua. Well, we cannot wait for that, and we'll get you on the air just before that fight happens, see how your training camp is going, see where your weight is at, and if you have any thoughts right before the fight.
No, ready to rumble.
Beautiful.
She may have it. She may be everything she said she is. Sweet tea is ready. I'm coming.
Sweet tea is ready. Sweet tea, Tanzee Daniel, we thank you very much here at Bullet Punch for taking the time out of your evening to discuss your upcoming fight with Mayorga in January, as well as your relationship with your manager, Sean Joynes. And how great is Molina Boxing Promotions? Have they taken good care of you?
Very good. Very good so far. Very good.
Awesome. All right. Sweet tea, Tanzee Daniel, we thank you, and we'll talk to you real soon.
Okay, pleasure.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.